You know, I've legitimately delayed this review, primarily due to my attempts at finding a way to write it without sounding like a complete shill or sellout or something. While yes, the Elgato green screen was sent free for review on the channel, I work with Elgato on a wide number of reviews, and I don't always have nice things to say. In fact, I had actually ordered the green screen myself on Amazon and was thankfully able to cancel the order upon learning that Elgato was sending one over for free. I thought that it was worth the price as soon as they announced it. So, spoiler alert, yeah, I have a lot of good things to say about this, but there's a couple things I'd like to see worked on or made available in the future, and I am personally not the biggest fan of the current trend of overusing green screens in the first place. Let's jump in right after this. Who? Orisa? Where?
Don't go around the corner.
Huh?
You better don't.
I just see a rock. Oh. Cool. Dude, will you just get a mod mic already? It attaches to any headphone so you can use that good pair that you like, but I'll actually be able to understand your callouts. It also has a mute switch so that I don't hear all those darn conversations with your grandma. We gotta get serious if we're gonna get out of Plaid. Yeah. Just order one tonight. Head on over to antlionaudio.com to learn more and check it out. I'm Meeples Fox, here to make tech easier and more fun, and today I'm reviewing a green screen. But it's not just a piece of green fabric with a brand name on it. This is a premium piece of kit designed to make your life easier while still being a simple concept. I've used three different forms of green screen, but they've never really made their way onto my channel. Why? Because the setup was far too cumbersome to ever keep up with within my small working spaces. In my bedroom back during my college years, I hung a wooden dowel from the ceiling with some hooks and ran a green screen on that. It technically worked, and I did a couple videos with it, but it was very hard to light in such a small space, maybe like 3 feet from that to the wall, including 2 feet of desk, and it divided the room way too much to really leave it up. I tried using a traditional backdrop stand, but again, having the space to leave it up sucked, and setup time was a nightmare. Plus, with both of these, rolling up or folding up the backdrop introduces all kinds of wrinkles that make the keying process even more difficult. Then, while interning for a local sports broadcast group, one of the main hosts just had one of his basement walls just covered in green paper with some clamp lights. An effective budget setup, but hard to light evenly, especially since it was so big and not something most people could commit to, myself included. And frankly, if you're not going to pull off a nice looking chroma key, just don't bother. It's obvious, it looks awful, and far inferior to just setting up a proper, decent looking backdrop in the first place. I had all but just given up on using a green screen pretty much ever. I still have a couple of old cloth screens, but they need to be cleaned and ironed before ever being useful. But then Elgato showed up and dropped the cam link and the green screen on us. This actually answers most of my issues with traditional setups. So the idea behind Elgato's green screen seems fairly obvious. It's one I actually looked for when I was trying my ceiling hun method circa 2012, but it's very effective here. Remember the pull-down projector screens from grade school? They hung on brackets off the wall and pulled out of a little box that always stayed in place and the screen stayed perfectly flat. This is the same concept, but flipped upside down. You have a nice metal case to enclose and protect the green screen, and it rolls out from there, remaining wrinkle-free and in perfect condition. You spread the balancing legs, open the case, and lift up on the handle to your desired height. The crossbar keeps it secure in place at any height up to 70.87 inches high. No extra switches, levers, anything required to lock it into place. It just sits there. Then when you're done, lightly push down and it rolls back up and you can store it under couches, under beds, anywhere really. This is a great system. The screen and case are 58.27 inches wide, big enough to cover the width of you sitting in a chair, but not too wide for most setups. Though if you have a super small setup, it might be too wide, but then you'd risk not having proper coverage for proper keying if you made it smaller. Height-wise, it goes up to just over 70 inches tall. This frustrates me a bit, just like 2 more inches and it'd be perfect for me to use standing up. But as is, I'd have to slouch quite awkwardly to make it work. I realize the purpose of this is fully for sitting down setups for streaming, but this would be the perfect screen for my post-production work too, with a little more height. To work around this, I would love to see a taller variant. I realize there's probably a limitation on height due to the crossbars engineering, but literally like 3 more inches for me personally would be great. I realize there are people taller than me and so on, so there's a rabbit hole to go down. I could, in theory, just set it up on some books or cinder blocks or something, but I don't have anything to do so in a secure manner and evenly, and this technically detracts from the easy setup gimmick for it. Alternatively, I would also love to see a modification or variant in which the case can also be hung from wall hooks, much like the projector screen I mentioned before, and extended downwards, so I could use the height to still use it while standing, since I don't need a green screen that goes all the way down to my feet. I was thinking I could do this with the screen and maybe make a separate project video, but unless I want to awkwardly hang it not at the top of my wall, but you know, down a few feet or so, it wouldn't reach down far enough to be fully effective that way either. The mechanisms to use the screen are great and feel high quality, and the green screen material itself feels super premium, and the fact that it stays wrinkle-free is just great. Here's a message I sent directly to the Elgato team, and I stand by this. It's a premium product for a slightly premium price, but far cheaper than any remotely similar professional products that I have found. My main concern would be if you left it up and your dog or cat decided to chew on it or scratch at it. It's a premium material, but if they ripped it enough, the spring mechanism inside the case could theoretically pull the bottom half back into the case and then it's ruined forever. But that's why it collapses into the protective case, right? And heck, your dog jumping on your green screen and tearing everything up midstream would be a pretty funny clip. Lastly, I did want to cover setting this up in software. This is still a green screen. You still need solid lighting for both you and the backdrop. Shadows will give you problems, like the ones you see here. Lack of light on you, as the subject, will also cause problems. This will also show up best with a proper camera, such as a camcorder or DSLR or mirrorless, fed into a capture card or the Elgato Camlink, conveniently launched at the same time. I see what you did there, Elgato. A webcam won't resolve the color or background separation as well as a formal camera, and if you have auto settings on, your face is about to get hella red. We'll go from most complicated to easiest solutions: OBS, XSplit, and Elgato's game capture software. In all of the options, just remember to crop off the extra framing around the green screen, and you're good to go. Let's start with OBS Studio. Add your face cam to your scene as you normally would. Once it's set up, right-click the source listing and click Filters. Here you can add lots of effects and edits to your audio and video sources, but under Effect Filters, click the plus sign. Here you can either use Color Key or Chroma Key. One may work better depending on your setup, but the intended purpose is basically the same. Pick one and choose your key color type, in this case green. This should automatically start to cut out some of the green. You can now use the controls for similarity, smoothness, and key color spill reduction to clean up your image. Similarity controls how much color similar to the chroma green it cuts out. If there's differences in lighting along your screen, you'll want to adjust this, being careful not to go too far and cutting out other colors. Smoothness smooths out edges and the overall keying of the color. Too much can start to dissolve the rest of you into your background, and that's not good either. Key color spill reduction aims to help reduce keying of other colors. But again, too much can cause problems. This filter also gives you controls for contrast, brightness, and gamma, but these should be left alone in most cases. This is something you need to adjust in your webcam settings or in your camera controls instead. Especially if your camera's already set on auto settings, adjusting these is not going to get you a good result because the auto settings are just going to keep kicking in and screwing with your color and all of that. In XSplit, add your webcam as normal to your scene. Right-click on the webcam either in your sources list or on the canvas, and click the Color tab. Towards the bottom, you can choose Color Key or Chroma Key. For Chroma Key, you choose the color green and adjust the threshold and exposure to adjust your image. You also have an anti-aliasing setting, which can help smooth out the jagged edges of the key, but that can impact your performance and your frame rate from the webcam and your overall stream. For Color Key, you can click the eyedropper tool to choose your background color, and then adjust threshold and exposure, as well as individual red, green, and blue levels to fix color issues. You also still have that anti-aliasing option there. In Elgato's game capture software, enable Stream Command. I have a full video detailing this feature linked in the video description. Add your webcam to your scene, or choose a scene with your webcam added, and click Edit Scene if it's not already in edit mode. click your webcam on the canvas and click the icon of a silhouette in a square for background removal. Click Enable Chroma Key, pick your color and adjust tolerance. Less control, but much simpler of a setup. The Elgato Green Screen takes a setup that has been reserved for the lowest in budget configurations or unaffordably high in setups and given us a mid-tier premium solution that will serve most streamers very well. I'm happy to have something to implement within my studio space for Chroma Keying for the first time ever, and I'm excited to see what future revisions of the product look like. Product links, as always, will be in the description below. Check out the Elgato Green Screen for yourself if you're interested. Otherwise, hit the like button if you enjoyed, subscribe for more educational tech content, and I will see you in the next one. 4K 60 Pro win? Epos Vox is a Patreon-supported production. Our videos would simply not be possible without the support and generosity of our patrons, whom you can see on screen now. If you'd like to join the inner circle and get early access to videos, among other benefits, go to patreon.com/eposvox to learn more.